Good Tuesday evening, everyone. I'm WDSU sports anchor Fletcher Macklin. Tonight, we are dedicating our entire sports segment to one big local topic. No, not the New Orleans Saints and their sloppy play recently. The New Orleans Pelicans and their ongoing search for a head coach. Recently, it was reported by ESPN that the Pelicans have reached out to Doc Rivers, one of the most accomplished head coaches on the market right now. The Pelicans are, of course, looking for a head coach because they fired Alvin Gentry last month. Joining us now to talk more about the search in Doc Rivers, Jake Madison from the podcast Locked On Pels. Jake, let's just start. Your thoughts on Doc Rivers?
Look, it sounds like the team already reached out to him, and it's rare that you get a head coach like this on the market. He's got a title. He's the 11th winningest coach all time. When you come with that pedigree and he's won everywhere he's coached, whether it's Orlando, whether it was the Boston Celtics, and now most recently with the Los Angeles Clippers, it's a guy with a pedigree like that is certainly going to get the buy-in of players like Zion Williamson, like Brandon Ingram, and you've got to at least make that call. I do wonder long-term if there's the greatest fit here between David Griffin and Doc Rivers, who both like to kind of be in charge and be in control. And we've heard that there have been reports that's really what caused some friction between Griff and Alvin Gentry. So I have concerns about that. But certainly he'd get the buy-in from the players. He would help build the kind of culture that New Orleans wants. And to be perfectly honest, when you look at the way that he handled the Donald Sterling situation with the Los Angeles Clippers a number of years ago, I do not know if there is a better leader in the NBA currently.
Jake, one NBA source tells me, don't be surprised to hear Jason Kidd's name linked to the Pelicans head coaching job. I don't really love that fit. What do you think when I say Jason Kidd in New Orleans Pelicans?
I cringe, to be perfectly honest, when I hear Jason Kidd's name first and foremost. There's some credibility there as a head coach. Giannis absolutely raves about him. He was the guy that thought to put Giannis in that point forward role that has really unlocked him to being the MVP level player that we've seen. But there's a lot of baggage there stemming from off-court interactions with family members to butting heads with the front office and getting a little dirty in that side of the political game interiors. And I don't know if that's what they're looking for when you're trying to kind of create an open culture, a collaborative culture here in New Orleans. But when you have a guy like Giannis vouch for you, and Giannis wanted to keep him as the head coach in Milwaukee when it was announced that he was being fired, that says something. The fact that he's a Hall of Fame player and can impart some of those skills to the young guys here in New Orleans, I think that's a good thing to look for.
Final question, Jake. When the dust settles, who is it going to be? Who'll be coaching Zion, Brandon Ingram in the Pelicans next season?
You know, I think their number one guy right now is Ty Lue, and I think they're waiting on him making a decision. And frankly, if he wants to win now, there's just better jobs available. So I don't see them going and getting him. But I think that means they want an established guy, a guy who's a known commodity and whose floor for this team is going to be higher than one of the unknown assistant coaches who are up and comers. They may have higher ceilings, but they want a guy that's at least going to get you into the playoffs, maybe get into the second round, and frankly, losing in the second round of the playoffs for this New Orleans Pelicans franchise would be a good thing. So a guy like Kenny Atkinson, who seems like he's going to get left out of maybe some of the bigger jobs available, but be there for New Orleans, seems to make a lot of sense. If I were reading the tea leaves, that's where I feel they're pointing right now.
Jake Madison, Locked On Pels, thank you very much for your time. Coming up on Wednesday, we'll hear from Saints quarterback Drew Brees as the Black and Gold get ready for a huge, dare I say, must-win game against Detroit, against the Lions. And that's a look at sports reporting from my home. I'm Fletcher Mackle, WDSU News.